Hi friends, today we are discussing about the photo identity card and its importance. Democracy is meaningless without fair and free elections, right? In order to have fair elections, there must be genuine voters. To ensure that the voters are genuine, they must be carry a proof of identity. To solve this problem, the parliament made a special provision to frame the required rules for the using electoral photo identity card to identify electors and prevent bogus voting during the elections. It is a precondition for the conduct of clean elections so that real voters can exercise their franchise and nobody else can vote in the place of the false identity. For the first time, the EPIC Electoral Photo Identity Card scheme was implemented in 1979 during the state assembly elections in Sikkim state. So, by 1996, about 52% of voters are issued EPICS. The Election Commission is authorized to issue photo identity card. These are the proof of identity of voters, identify the cards with the photographs of voters as well as other necessary details also. Now we are coming to the polling. The large number of polling booths is set up in each constituency. When we go for the voting, we will see that kind of booths. Each booth has a staff of 5 or 6 persons comprising a presiding officer. 3 or 4 other officers also will be there and an attendant. So these are the persons. The presiding officer is in charge of maintaining discipline and conducting a polling under his supervision in the booth. Now, what is the situation of the polling day? On the polling day, voters stand in a queue in orderly manner. The Election Commission has now made it mandatory for adult voters to bring their photo identity card along with them. They can also bring other proof of identity. As a voter enter of the booth and his or her, that may be male or female, identity is verified by the polling officer. Mark of index on the finger of the left hand, he or she then go behind a screen, an enclosure to cast her or his vote through the secret ballot. The voter can either cast the vote by marking the ballot paper with a rubber stamp against the candidate name or the symbol, or vote through electronic voting machine by just pressing the button against the appropriate symbol. Since 1998, the commission has increasingly using the electronic voting machines instead of ballot boxes. These electronic voting machine have, it is really one of the best option we can say comparing to the ballot boxes. All these in a queue at the time of the closing polling are allowed to cast their vote. A special bill was passed in the parliament in 2003 February by armed forces. Personnel were provided with a system of proxy voting so that they can also cast their vote even when they are not present in their constituency. This proxy voting, this you have to remind, right? They can vote through postal ballot, or they may give authority to someone to vote on their behalf, of also called the proxy voting. Now the situation come to the counting and the declaration of the results. After polling is completed, the ballot boxes or the electronic voting machines are sealed and then shifted to the counting centers under strict security. On a fixed date, usually immediately after the polling day, counting of the votes begin in the presence of the candidates and the members of the various parties. Counting is done under the supervision of the returning officer. In case of any doubt or argument, his or her decision is a final. As soon as the counting is over, the candidate securing the maximum number of the voters is declared elected the returning officer. This is known as a simple majority system. If more than one candidate secured the same number of maximum votes, the decision is taken by the draw of lots in the presence of the candidates involved and under supervision of the returning officer. Thank you.